أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط صدق الله العظيم.
الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا من طيبات ما كسبتم ومما أخرجنا لكم من الأرض ولا تيمموا الخبيث منه تنفقون ولستم بآخذيه إلا أن تغمزوا فيه واعلموا أن الله غني حميد الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم يُؤْتِ الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا وَمَا يَذَّكَّرُ إِلَّا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ صدق الله العظيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي اللهم ربنا ارحمنا بالقرآن العظيم واجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة اللهم ذكرنا منهما نسينا وعلمنا منهما جهلنا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وآناء النهار واجعله لنا حجة يا رب العالمين آمين The same subject of infaq fi sabilillah is continuing. The full preceding section, that is section 36 of Surah Al-Baqarah, that was also fully occupied by this discussion about infaq fi sabilillah. And this section 37th is also fully occupied by this discussion. Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu anfiqu min tayyibati ma kasabtum. O you who believe, or O you who profess to believe, expend and spend in the way of Allah when good things that you have earned, طَيِّبَاتِ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ وَمِمَّا أَخْرَجْنَا لَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ, or from which that we have brought forth from the earth for you, وَلَا تَيَمَّمُ الْخَبِيثَ مِنْهُ, and don't aim at something which is bad from that, تُنْفِقُونَ وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِيهِ, that you will spend it for the cause of Allah, for charity, for giving it to poor, something which is bad. وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِيهِ, and if some occasion arises and you need and somebody gives you that type of thing, you will not be able to accept it. You will not accept it yourself. إِلَّا أَن تُغْمِزُوا فِيهِ, unless you close your eyes on it. So it will be difficult to accept such a thing which you want to give to others. وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ, you should keep in mind that Allah is ghani. You are not giving to this poor person, you are giving to Allah. For the sake of Allah you are giving. You are giving it to Allah actually. So you should give the best, not the worst. He is ghani. وَاللَّهُ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ, he is self-sufficient, praiseworthy. الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرُ, Shaitan threatens you, make you fear poverty. If you spend for the cause of Allah, you will become poor. You will have nothing. وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ, in addition, he enjoins upon you to indecency. وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ, on the contrary, Allah is promising with you مَغْفِرَةً مِّنْهُ, forgiveness from him. وَفَضْلَ and bounty. وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ, and Allah is all-embracing, knowing everything. Yuti al-hikmata man yasha. He gives the true wisdom to whomsoever he pleases. Wa man yuta al-hikmata. And whosoever has been given and granted wisdom, the real wisdom, faqad utiya khairan kaseera, he has been given the biggest good, khair kaseer, wa ma yazakkaru illa ulul albab. And only those who have real understanding, they get the admonition and they get the real advice. Now what does it mean here? You cannot spend the best of your wealth for the way of Allah unless you have the real wisdom that everything that you have here is for this world. And this world is temporary. It's not everlasting. And whatever you are spending for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is for the other world. And that is lasting. بَلْ تُوْسِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. Your real disease, your real mistake is that you prefer this world, the life of this world, while actually the life of the next world, the life of hereafter, that is much better and that is everlasting. So real wisdom is this. Whosoever has understood this point, not only that he professes that he believes in it, it is ingrained in his heart, it is there as a conviction. He has the real hikmah, he has the real wisdom. And then you know, the wisdom of all other things will also become apparent to him. His inner eyes will, so to say, be opened. يُوْتِ الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَاءَ وَمَنْ يُوْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ نَفَقَةٍ أَوْ نَذَرْتُمْ مِنْ نَذْرٍ. And whatsoever you spend, any spending that you do, and every vow that you make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nazr, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُهُ. Allah knows it. Don't try to proclaim it loudly. Because if you are doing it for Allah, Allah knows it. Allah knows everything, even if it is in your mind and in your heart only. Because you know this sadaqah nafila, as far as zakah, that is the obligatory charity. As far as it is concerned, it is to be given openly to the government, Islamic State. It's not to be concealed or it shouldn't be hidden. But sadaqat nafila, additional spending that you do for this pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that shouldn't be declared. If you declare, okay, at least you are giving something, at least it can be beneficial, it will be used somewhere. But the best thing is, you conceal it. You keep it a secret. And the wordings that have appeared in one of the ahadiths is that what your right hand spends, let not your even your own left hand know it. You are spending with your right hand. Even your left hand shouldn't know that you have done it. That would be actually, that will have the privilege that this is exclusively for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and there's no riya and no showing off in it. وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ نَفَقَةٍ أَوْ نَذَرْتُمْ مِنْ نَذْرٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُهُ. Whatsoever you spend and whatsoever you owe to spend, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows it. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنْصَارٍ. But there will be no helpers for the wrongdoers, for the unjust. إِن تُبْدُوا الصَّدَقَاتِ فَنِعِمَّا هِيَ. If you disclose and proclaim your charity, well, this is also okay. At least you are giving something, at least some needs will be fulfilled by that. وَإِن تُوتُوهَا وَإِن تُخْفُوهَا وَتُوتُوهَا الْفُقَرَاءَ. And if you conceal it, if you keep it a secret and give away to the people who are needy, فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ, that is much better for you. Because then actually there will be no doubt of riya and sum'ah that you wanted to show off, you wanted to get the praise of the people. If that is the case, you will have no reward on the Day of Judgment. That will carry no weight in the balance of the hereafter. وَيُكَفِّرُ عَنْكُمْ مِنْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will acquit you of your evil deeds due to that sadaqah that you have made in secrecy. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. And whatever you are doing, Allah is well aware of it. لَيْسَ عَلَيْكَ هُدَاهُمْ. Now after all this persuasion, people are not ready to spend for the cause of Allah, for the pleasure of Allah, what could Muhammad do, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reassuring him. Don't be grieved, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If even after all these ayat having been revealed, there are people in Medina who are wealthy, but who are keeping their wealth with them, the munafiqeen, they didn't want to spend for the cause of Allah. They were all of them very, very rich people. But if they are not doing it, لَيْسَ عَلَيْكَ هُدَاهُمْ. It is not your responsibility to give them the guidance. You can't give it. It's not in your power. You don't have the authority. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given every human being a choice. It's his own choice. He can take any choice. He can choose anything. He can take any direction. إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. So don't be grieved. لَيْسَ عَلَيْكَ هُدَاهُمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. This authority is only with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He gives guidance to whomsoever He likes. He can change the heart of a person. The Prophet had said that the hearts of all human beings are within the two fingers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يُصَرِّفُ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ. He can turn the heart of the persons in whichever direction he likes. These hearts are in the two fingers, between the two fingers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the Prophet didn't have that authority. It has been said to him, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. You cannot give guidance to whomsoever you like. This is exclusive authority of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He gives the guidance to whomsoever He likes. لَيْسَ عَلَيْكَ هُدَاهُمْ. Don't be grieved. لَيْسَ عَلَيْكَ هُدَاهُمْ. The responsibility is not yours. You will not be questioned. As we read yesterday, وَلَا تُسْأَلُ عَنْ أَصْحَابِ الْجَحِيمِ. You will not be questioned about these people, why they went to Jahannam when you were there, when we sent you, even after your advent, why such a great number of people are going to Jahannam? It's not responsibility. You are not responsible. You are not questionable on that account. لَيْسَ عَلَيْكَ هُدَاهُمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَلِأَنفُسِكُمْ. And whatsoever you spend, O Muslims, know that you are doing it for your own self. You will get the reward in the hereafter. Don't think you are doing good to somebody else. It's for your own self. وَمَا تُنْفِقُونَ إِلَّا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ اللَّهِ. And that also, if you are spending only for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If there is some pollution, some wrong intention is there, you want some praise from the people, that he is very sakhi, he is a person of charity, then you know even that is gone. Then it's the wastage. You will get nothing in the hereafter also. So now here, after the persuasion, you know, this is inzar. If you are spending, see that you are spending with pure intentions. If there is pollution in the intentions, then you will get nothing. لَيْسَ عَلَيْكَ هُدَاهُمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَلِأَنفُسِكُمْ وَمَا تُنْفِقُونَ إِلَّا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ اللَّهِ وَمَا تُنْفِقُونَ مِنْ خَيْرٍ يُوَفَّ إِلَيْكُمْ. And if you are spending for the pleasure of Allah, and solely and exclusively, then it will be given to you in full. The reward will be given to you in full. وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تُسْلَمُونَ. And you will not be wronged. You will not be deprived of your due rewards. Now comes that ayah which I mentioned in the very beginning. All this infaq for whom? Sadaqat are for the poor. Sadaqah always for poor. But infaq fi sabilillah, for whom? لِلْفُقَرَاءِ الَّذِينَ أُحْسِرُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ لَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ ضَرْبًا فِي الْأَرْضِ يَحْسَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُ أَغْنِيَاءَ مِنَ التَّعَفُّفِ تَعْرِفُهُمْ بِسِيمَاهُمْ لَا يَسْأَلُونَ النَّاسَ إِلْحَافًا وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِهِ عَلِيمٌ. لِلْفُقَرَاءِ. This infaq is for those people those needy people, allazeena uhsiru fi sabilillah, who have been surrounded in the cause of Allah, who have been encircled in the cause of Allah. Hisar, you know, mahsoor. Mahsoor is one who is surrounded. There is no way out. He is mahsoor. Muhasara. Allazeena uhsiru fi sabilillah, who have been surrounded, confined, wholly occupied, whole time occupied for the cause of Allah. They have dedicated their lives. They are doing no business. They are not in any profession now. They have given up everything. They have dedicated all their life, all their time, all energies, all capabilities for the cause of Allah. And I told you, unless there is a big number, not only one or two, of such persons, no revolution can be brought about. It is not a part-time job. You can do tabligh part-time. Tabligh can be done part-time. Teaching can be done part-time. But iqamatuddin, to establish the deen of Allah, to change the political socio-economic order, which requires a revolutionary struggle, that is impossible. There should be hundreds and hundreds of people who devote whole time, total energies, exclusively for this cause. Now they have to be fed. They are also human beings. They have to be looked after. Who will do it? The brethren who are doing it still part-time, they are also working for that deen, for that movement, for that revolution, but still they are part-time. They are earning also. They should share their earning with those brothers who have devoted themselves whole time, wholehearted. So this is actually the best use of infaq fi sabilillah. Lil fuqara'i alladhina uhsiru fi sabilillah la yastati'una darban fil ard. They cannot travel in the world, on the earth. You know, business was done on those days mostly by traveling. Export, import. The Prophet used to lead caravans before wahi started coming to him. He was taking caravans to Syria. So actually, but there, now, when the wahi came to him, when he was engaged in this dawah, in his mission, now after that he couldn't do. He couldn't go anywhere to do business. He never took any other caravan after that. And he didn't do any work to earn his livelihood. He had some money of Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. That was there sufficient for him in his Makki period, but in Madani period. Actually, it were the gifts of the people, the hadaya. And then, you know, when the battle started, then the ghanima, the al-anfal, the fay, these were the sources of his income, of his livelihood. After all, he had 9 wives at one time, and he had to feed them. Then relatives, all these things were there. Then there were the ashab-e-suffa. Who were they? They were the whole-timers. They were not doing any business. They were whole time in the mosque, learning Quran, learning Hadith. Whatsoever is being revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they are learning it. At Makkah even, so many young people, youth, they were whole-timers. Khabbab ibn al-Ard, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Abdullah ibn Umm Maktoum, and then, you know, Mus'ab ibn Umair, radiallahu ta'ala, the Prophet sent him to Medina. How could he go to Medina? Because he had actually devoted all his life. So he could go to Medina. So that is, you know, you should have the history before you. لِلْفُقَرَاءِ الَّذِينَ أُحْسِرُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ لَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ ضَرْبًا فِي الْأَرْضِ. They cannot go about on the earth doing business. يَحْسَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُ أَغْنِيَاءَ مِنَ التَّعَفُّفِ. Because they don't ask, due to their humility and modesty, people think they are rich, but they are not asking. They are not begging. لَا يَسْأَلُونَ النَّاسَ تَعْرِفُهُمْ بِسِيْمَاهُمْ. You will recognize them with their faces, with their looks. If somebody is in need, even if he is not asking, you can see it written on his face. If you have the idea, they will never ask. لَا يَسْأَلُونَ النَّاسَ إِلْحَافَ. They are not beggars. They won't beg the people importunately. وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِهِ عَلِيمٍ. And whatever wealth and money you spend, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala verily knows it. So this is the final ayah on this subject. This is the last ayah of the 37th section of Suratul Baqarah. Here these two sections regarding infaq fi sabilillah come to an end. And now you know, directly opposed to infaq is riba. What is infaq? We have read the ayah, يَسَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ قُلِ الْعَفْوِ. Whatever is surplus with you, you give away for the cause of Allah. Give away to the needy in the form of sadqah. Give away for the deen of Allah, for infaq fi sabilillah. This is infaq. What is riba? Whatever is surplus with you, you invest, so that you earn more. And the worst form of earning is that you want to get the benefit, you want to get the profit at a fixed rate. You don't care whether the person to whom you have given that money, whether he is earning or losing. You must get your pound of flesh. That is riba. So these are absolutely different. It's absolutely opposite to each other. That is why the same principle of contrast. After these two sections on infaq, now you have one section of this surah on riba, which is diagonally opposite to infaq fi sabilillah. The spirit of infaq is whatever is surplus with you, whatever is more than you need, give it away. Don't keep it with you. And give it away for the sake of Allah. If you are investing it to gain more, well, if you want to do it, but through halal means, that is permissible at least. Although it is not that position, that is the highest position, you give away. Everything that is surplus, you give away. يَسَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ قُلِ الْعَفْوَ. But if you don't give away, you give it to someone as loan, goodly loans, without getting any interest or riba on it, so that he can fulfill his needs for the time being. Or you invest in muzaraba or something else, which is legally permissible according to the Sharia, then it is okay. Although it is a lower level, the higher level is that you give it away. مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ قُلِ الْعَفْوَ. But if you go more lower than that, you give it on riba, you don't want to take the risk. In muzaraba, that is great risk. If there is loss, you lose all your money. The whole capital money is gone in muzaraba. You are not ready to take that risk. And now you are giving on riba. This is absolutely haram. And the most biggest haram in Islam is riba. Nothing is like riba in Islam. Please note it. The biggest crime, the biggest sin is riba. And that will be clear from this section. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ. Again here, infaq first. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to show us the contrast. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً. Those people who spend their wealth and their money, their belongings for the pleasure of Allah, بِاللَّيْلِ during the night, وَالنَّهَارِ as well as during the day, سِرًّا secretly also, as well as alaniyatan and openly also, فَلَهُمْ مَجْرُهُمْ إِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. For them is their reward. It is ensured with their Lord. وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. There will be no fear upon them, nor they will be grieving. In contrast now begin, الَّذِينَ يَعْقُلُونَ الرِّبَى. On the other hand, to the contrary, those who are eating, endeavoring interest and usury. Please note, always in riba, use two words for translation, not one. Usury as well as interest, both are covered by riba. There shouldn't be any doubt in the mind of any Muslim. Both are covered by riba. And it is a very historical incident that has happened in Pakistan, in our country, that the highest court, the Sharia court, federal Sharia court, that has given the final judgment that the bank interest, commercial interest, is also covered by riba. It is also riba. There's no doubt about it. A very big document has been prepared although there were people who opposed it, that riba is only usury. This commercial interest or bank interest is not riba. Very big lawyers of the level of stature of S.M. Zafar, must be knowing many of people here, must be knowing him, and Khalid Ishaq, one from Punjab, the other from Karachi, both did their best to prove that the bank interest is not riba. But the court gave the final judgment. It's very authentic judgment. A very big feat indeed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enabled the Muslims there to do. Although these things are only on paper. In practice, everything there is the same as anywhere else. As in here, as anywhere else. But at least this theory, this has been proved, and this is the judgment of a court. That is why I am using both the words. Allazina yaakuluna riba. Those who are eating and devouring, usury or interest. La yaqumuna illa kama yaqumu alladhi yataqabbatuhu allahu min al-mas. He doesn't stand or he will not rise except as like the one whom shaitan has maddened by his touch. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ قَالُوا إِنَّمَا الْبَيْعُ مِثْلُ الرِّبَا. And this is because they have said that trade is also just like riba, usury, interest. وَأَحَلَّ اللَّهُ الْبَيْعَ وَحَرَّمَ الرِّبَا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared bay', trading, as permissible. وَحَرَّمَ الرِّبَا. And He has declared haram. He has declared absolutely impermissible what is riba, that is interest as well as usury. فَمَنْ جَاهُ مَعْزَةٌ. So to whomsoever this admonition has come, مِنْ رَبِّهِ, from his Lord, فَانْتَهَا. And he stops taking riba, eating riba. فَلَهُ مَا سَلَفْ. So he will not be deprived of, and he can keep with him the gains of the past, whatsoever he has had up till now, on account of that riba, he can keep it. وَأَمْرُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. But his matter is with Allah. Allah will decide about him. It's not the clean slate. It's only the legal aspects here. You can keep. Up till now, whatever you have earned through riba, keep it. Now, because that admonition has come to you, now you have to stop. For whatever you have earned, now it cannot be accounted. No account can show up till now how much he has earned through riba, how much he has been earning through lawful means. So it is because impossible. So keep it. It will not be investigated into, and that will remain with you. فَلَهُ مَا سَلَفْ. He can keep it. وَأَمْرُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. But the matter rests with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ عَادَ. But whosoever repeats and reverts to riba, even after this final declaration of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. So they are the people of fire, and they will remain in it forever, forever. يَمْحَقُ اللَّهُ الرِّبَا. Allah blots out and destroys riba. وَيُرْبِ الصَّدَقَاتِ. He augments the sadaqat, the charity. وَاللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ كَفَّارٍ أَثِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not love any ungrateful sinner. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتَمُوا الزَّكَاةَ لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. Verily those who have faith and who have done good deeds and who have established prayers and who have been paying zakah, لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. For them their reward is ensured with their Lord. وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. And there will be no fear on them, nor will they grieve. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَا إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. A very passionate plea again. O you who profess to believe, have taqwa of Allah. Fear Him. Have the fear of Day of Judgment. اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَا. And give up what remains from the usury or interest. إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. If you are real mu'min. فَإِن لَمْ تَفَعْلُوا. And now if you don't do it, فَأَذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. So receive a notice of war from Allah and His Messenger. Be noted, be notified of a challenge of war from Allah and His Messenger. Wa in tubtum, and if you repent, if you give up this riba, this business, falakum ru'usum wa alaykum, you shall have the right to get your capital sums. La tazlimuna wa la tuzlamun. You not wronging others, and likewise, yourself not be wronged. You do wrong to others, and don't be wronged yourself. Wa in kana dhu usratin, and if your debtor, if he is in difficulty, is having hard time, he cannot pay your capital sum even, فَنَّذِرَةٌ إِلَىٰ مَيْسَرَةٌ. So there should be respite, grant him more time, so that he can pay with ease. وَأَن تَصَدَّقُوا فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. وَأَن تَصَدَّقُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. And if you give it away in charity, you just limit it in charity, you say that, oh, if you cannot repay my debt, oh, I give it to you, I forgo it. It's hiba from me, or hadiya from me, it is sadaqa from me, it is better for you. Because the best thing was from the very beginning, don't keep surplus with you. Don't try to earn more through surplus. Surplus is actually meant for something else. يَسَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ قُلِ اللَّهُ. That is to be spent for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to be kept with you. So in the beginning if you couldn't do it, now because your debtor, you know, he is in difficulty, he cannot repay. Now at least, you forgive it to him. Say now that it is sadaqah. فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَأَن تَصَدَّقُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. If you have the real knowledge. وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. And have the fear of that day when you will be returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا كَسَبَتْ. Then every soul shall be paid in full what it has earned. وَهُمْ لَا يُسْلَمُونَ. And they will not be wronged. They will not be deprived of their rewards. Now, because connected with riba is another economic affair, and that is loan. Any transaction in which there is some sort of loan, what to do about it? يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا تَدَايَنْتُمْ بِدَيْنٍ. O you who believe or profess to believe, when you contract a debt for a fixed term, إِذَا تَدَايَنْتُمْ بِدَيْنٍ إِلَىٰ عَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. In then, in loan, there must be a fixed time, specified time. This is a qarz, this is a loan for 2 years, 1 year, 6 months, a specified period must be there. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا تَدَايَنْتُمْ بِدَيْنٍ إِلَىٰ عَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى فَاكْتُبُوهُ. Write it down. There should be a writing. وَلْيَكْتُبْ بَيْنَكُمْ كَاتِبٌ بِالْعَدْلِ. And the scribe should write it for you. But he should write with justice. He shouldn't change, you know, the wordings. Because a slight change in the wordings can mean a lot in the end. بِالْعَدْلِ. وَلْيَكْتُبْ بَيْنَكُمْ كَاتِبٌ بِالْعَدْلِ. وَلَا يَعْبَ كَاتِبٌ أَنْ يَكْتُبَ كَمَا عَلَّمَهُ اللَّهُ فَلْيَكْتُبْ. And no scribe should refuse from writing, should refuse to write. He should write just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught him writing. This art Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon him, so he shouldn't refuse. وَلْيُمْلِلِ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِ الْحَقُّ. And to the writer, to the scribe, the dictation should be given by the person on whom is loan. The debtor should dictate the wordings. On whom is the haqq? وَلْيَتَّقِ اللَّهَ رَبَّهُ. And he should keep the fear of Allah in his mind. وَلَا يَبْخَسْ مِنْهُ شَيْعًا. And while dictating the terms, he shouldn't deprive anything. He should not diminish anything from it. فَإِنْ كَعَلَى الَّذِي عَلَيْهِ الْحَقُّ سَفِيهًا. And if the person who owes the debt is someone of low understanding, safihan, or za'ifan, or he is weak, or la yastati'u an yumilla huwa, or if he is unable to dictate on account of any other reason, فَلْيُمْلِلْ وَلِيُّهُ بِالْعَدْلِ then in that case, his guardian should dictate, but he should also dictate with justice, with honesty. وَاسْتَشْهَدُوا شَهِدَيْنَ مِنْ رِجَالِكُمْ and get two witnesses from your men on this transaction, on this writing, you should get two witnesses from your men. فَإِنْ لَمْ يَكُونَ رَجُلَيْنَ if you don't find two men, فَرَجُلٌ وَمْرَاتَانَ so one man and two women. مِمَّنْ تَرْضَوْنَ مِنَ الشُّهَدَاءِ from amongst those about you are agree about witnesses, whom you like, approve as witnesses. So primarily, in the first place, there should be two men. If two men are not available, then one man and two women. أَنْ تَظِلَّ إِهْدَاهُمَا فَتُذَكِّرَ إِهْدَاهُمَا الْأُخْرَىٰ so that if one of those women, if she errs, then the other woman might be able to remind her. وَلَا يَعْبَ الشُّهَدَاءُ إِذَا مَا دُعُوا and the witnesses should not refuse when they are summoned to give evidence. وَلَا تَسْعَمُوا أَنْ تَكْتُبُوهُ صَغِيرًا وَكَبِيرًا and don't feel it burdensome that you write, although it might be a small affair or a big affair. When it is of loan, the transaction is entails some debt, then you must write it, whether it is a small amount or a big amount, sagiran or kabiran, ila ajalihi, and that time limit must also be prescribed and specified. Zalikum aqsatu indallah. This is more equitable and just in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَلِكُمْ أَقْسَطُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَأَقْوَمُ لِلشَّهَادَةِ and this is more confirmatory for testimony. وَأَدْنَا اللَّهَ تَرْتَابُ and this is more likelier that you will not doubt. إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ تِجَارَةً حَاضِرَةً تُدِيرُونَهَا بَيْنَكُمْ except if it is a trade presently between you, going on between you, hand to hand, تَدِيرُونَهَا بَيْنَكُمْ فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاهٌ if it is all cash transaction, يَدَمْ بَيَدٍ with one hand you are paying the money, with the other hand you are getting your material, whatever you have purchased. So this is cash. فَلَا جُنَاهَا عَلَيْهِ أَلَّا تَكْتُبُوهَا فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاهٌ أَلَّا تَكْتُبُوهَا then there is no sin on you, no blame on you if you don't write it down. This order, this command of writing, that is actually for loan and debts. وَأَشْهَدُوا إِذَا تَبَايَعْتُمْ but there can be some trading also, which you call, you know, forward trading. It's not the present exchange. Not you are buying anything and selling anything, but you are making an agreement of a later day exchange. This is called tabayatum. وَأَشْهَدُوا إِذَا تَبَايَعْتُمْ and whenever you make a commercial contract, you must have witnesses. وَلَا يُضَارَّ كَاتِبٌ وَلَا شَهِيدٌ neither the scribe or the writer of the document should be harmed, nor the witnesses should be harmed, because he has given the evidence which has proved to be against me. Now you become an enemy of that witness. That is wrong. Whosoever will do it, وَإِنْ تَفْعَلُوا فَإِنَّهُ فَسُوقٌ بِكُمْ if you do it, then it is something very bad from your side. It is rebellious in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ and have taqwa of Allah. Fear Allah. Keep Allah in mind. Regard Him as He should be regarded. وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ and see, Allah is teaching you. How detailed teaching He is giving you. وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ Allah is teaching you. وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ and definite Allah knows everything. This is the longest ayah of the Quran. This is one ayah. And you know it has a full law. A full, you know, book can be written on this law. وَإِن كُنْتُمْ عَلَىٰ سَفَرٍ وَلَمْ تَجِدُوا كَاتِبًا. And if you are on some journey and you don't find any scribe, maybe the scribe is not there, the writer is not there, then the shuhada are not available. It things like happen in journeying. Nobody knows you that he can give evidence and he is ready to be a witness to any contract. وَإِن كُنْتُمْ عَلَىٰ سَفَرٍ وَلَمْ تَجِدُوا كَاتِبًا فَرِحَانٌ مَقْبُوضًا. Then there should be a pledge in hand, that is what we call mortgage. Something of some property of that person that should come in the occupation of the person who is giving the debt. In hand, mortgage, maqbooz. فَرِحَانٌ مَقْبُوضًا. فَإِنْ أَمِنَ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا فَلْيُوَدِّ الَّذِي أُطِمِنَ أَمَانَتَهُ وَلْيَتَّقِ اللَّهَ رَبَّهُ. But if one of you trusts the other, then the one who is trusted should deliver his trust and let him fear Allah, his Lord, and do not conceal testimony. وَلَا تَكْتُمُوا الشَّهَادَةَ. Never conceal and hide testimony. وَمَنْ يَكْتُمْهَا. Whosoever conceals or hides testimony, فَإِنَّهُ آثِمٌ قَلْبَهُ. He is making his heart sinful. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ عَلِيمٌ. And whatsoever you are doing, Allah knows it. Now we come to the last section. It's a very small section in its size, only 3 ayat, but most profound. And this we will see inshallah later on. This is the general case in most of the surahs of the Quran. The ayat with which the surah begins and the ayat with which the surah ends, they are very profound. The ayat in the beginning of Suratul Baqarah, وَأَلِفْ لَامْ مِيمْ ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Most profound. Whosoever wants to avail of the guidance of this book, he must produce in his character these attributes, these qualities. And then only he will be really availing the benefits of the guidance of Quran. Now here to end up these 3 ayat, they are very profound. Last 2 ayat, about that, about these there is a tradition. These ayat were not revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on earth. They were presented to him as a gift for the ummah on the night of Miraj, ascension to heaven. All the rest of the Quran descended from the heaven to the earth to be revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the last 2 ayat of Suratul Baqarah, Muhammad went up to the heavens in the Laylatul Isra. And there he was given these 2 ayat, last 2 ayat. And about these 2 ayat, the wordings in the hadith are that they are 2 treasures from the treasure beneath the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Taht al-Arsh. They are the 2 big prayers that were gifted for the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and given to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of Miraj, on the day of Isra, on the night of Isra. Not the first, only the last 2 ayat. The first is Lillahi ma fi samawati wa ma fi al-ard. These wordings are included in the Ayatul Kursi also, and they have been repeated so many times in the Quran. Everything, all that is in the heavens and that is on the earth belongs to Allah. He is the only rightful owner of everything in this world. We are not the owners, please mind it. We are the custodians. We are only under the wrong notion. We own. I own this house. I own this car. I own this body. No. We are only custodians. E amanat chand roza nizd maast, dar haqeeqat malik-e har shay khudaast. This is actually a sacred trust of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with us. We are only trustees and nothing else. Lillahi ma fi samawati wa ma fi al-ard. Wa in tubdu ma fi anfusikum wa tukhfuhu. Whether you disclose whatsoever is in your hearts and minds, this word nafs, it includes heart and mind both. Nafs fi anfusikum. What you have in your heart, what you have in your mind. Whether you disclose it out of fuho or you hide it, conceal it, yuhasibkum bihi Allah will bring you forth to the task, to the accountability. You will have to account for it before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Although you might be hiding it, He knows what is in your hearts, so He will ask you about your intentions even. وَإِنْ تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبْكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ فَيَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيُعَظِّمُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ Then He will pardon and forgive whomsoever He wills, whomsoever He will please. And He will give the torment and the punishment to whomsoever He wills, to whomsoever He pleases. It is His exclusive authority. This is a belief with the Ahl Sunnah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the total authority. If He punishes an innocent person, He can do it. He has the authority. Because He is Malik, He is owner. He can do anything to what He belongs to Him. If He forgives the worst sinner, it is His authority. Although we know He will punish the sinner, and He will reward, give good reward to people who did good deeds. But He has the authority. He can do whatever He likes. يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ مَا يُرِيدُ يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ Whatever He likes, He will do. And He has the authority to do it. لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَإِنْ تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبْكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ فَيَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيُعَظِّمُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ Allah has the authority over everything. آمَنَ الرَّسُولُ Now these are the two ayat from under the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the prayer, the two gems and the two diamonds of the prayer under the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which were given to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the night of Isra. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger, he believed in what was revealed to him, in what was sent down to him from his Lord. And so did the believers. We can have pride in it. That the first mu'min was Muhammad himself sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. آمن الرسول He also had iman. He also testified. He also attested that whatever has been sent on my heart, has been sent down to my heart through Archangel Jibreel, this is from Rabb, this is from Allah. Tabaraka wa ta'ala. Aamana ar-rasoolu bima unzila ilayhi min rabbihi wal mu'minun. May Allah include us in those mu'minun. كُلٌّ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَكُتُبِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ Who are those mu'minun? All who believe in Allah and His angels and His books and all His messengers. لَا نُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِّن رُسُلِهِ And we don't discriminate between any of His messengers. This appeared in the 16th section also. لَا نُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِّن رُسُلِهِ And here again, why? Because you know the half of this surah was addressed towards the people of the book, but Israel. They believe in Moses, but they don't believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They don't believe in Jesus alayhi salatu wa sallam. And these Christians, they believe in all, including Hazrat Masih, but they don't believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As a contrast we are saying, and we have been taught to say it repeatedly, we believe in all the messages of Allah. We believe in all the books that were sent down. So we don't discriminate between even one of the messengers of Allah. لَا نُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِّن رُسُلِهِ وَقَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا May Allah give us the courage to say these words from the depths of our heart. سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا Oh Allah, we have listened and we have accepted. We submit to you. We accept your commands. سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا غُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا We ask you your forgiveness. O our Lord, we ask you, we request you for your forgiveness. وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرُ And we very well know that we have to go back to you. We have to go to you. إِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرُ وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرُ لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. Allah doesn't hold responsible any soul except according to his capacity. He knows what he has given to me, how much intelligence he has given to me, how much physical strength he has given to me, how much power of understanding things he has given to me. He knows what he has given to you. And there will be accountability, personal accountability. Every person separately, he will be judged according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him. He has to account for everything that Allah gave him. So there will not be one level of judging all the human beings. Every human being will be judged on the basis of what he was given. He knows the genes which were given to me and the genes which were given to you. What are the limitations of my genes? And what are the potentialities of your genes? Whatsoever he has given to any human being, he will judge him on the basis of that given faculties and that given capacity. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت. For every soul is what it has earned. And on every soul would be whatever it has earned against itself. The sins, the wrongs that we have done, we have made something, we have earned something against our own selves. For it is that which it has earned, and against it is that which it has deserved. رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَاخِذْنَا. Now this is the prayer, the longest prayer that has appeared in the Quran. You will find these prayers, at many places. But this is, in one ayah, the longest prayer. Otherwise, in the last section of Surah Al-Imran, I think if we count the total, that prayer will become longer than this. But that is included in three ayat. But this is total in one ayah. رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَاخِذْنَا إِن نَسِيْنَا وَأَخْطَأْنَا. O our Lord, don't take us to task if we forget. وَأَخْطَأْنَا. Or if we commit an error without an intention, without an unintentional error. خَطَى means unintentional error. رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَاخِذْنَا. Don't take us to task if we forget and if we commit some error unintentionally. رَبَّنَا وَلَا تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْنَا إِصْرًا كَمَا حَمَلْتَهُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِنَا. O our Lord, don't put on our shoulders the burden that you put on those who were before us, the former Muslim Ummah, or the people who had faith formerly. You put them to hardest test. O Allah, we are weak. Don't put us to such strict and hard tests. Don't put upon us the burden. Lay not on us a burden like that which thou didst lay on those before us. رَبَّنَا وَلَا تُحَمِّلْنَا مَا لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا بِهِ. O our Lord, don't impose upon us for which we don't have the power and strength to bear. وَعْفُ عَنَّا. And pardon us. وَغْفِرْ لَنَا. And forgive us. وَرْحَمْنَا. Have mercy on us. أَنْتَ مَوْلَانَا. You are our protector, our guardian, our supporter. فَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. So help us against the disbelieving people. This we may say that the prayer that we read in the section which discussed the battle between Talut and Jalut, that was the brief expression of this very long prayer. And this was taught to the Muslims why? Because now they were going to have the battle at Badr. Now there was going to be confrontation. The revolutionary struggle of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had entered that final phase of armed conflict. Now they were going to be required to lay down their lives. Because whosoever goes to war, whosoever goes to a battlefield, he is risking his life. He takes his life on his hands. If he returns, it's actually a new life. So actually for this dua, رَبَّنَا لَا تُعَاخِذْنَا إِن نَسِيْنَا وَأَخْطَانَا رَبَّنَا وَلَا تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْنَا عِسْرًا كَمَا حَمَلْتَهُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِنَا رَبَّنَا وَلَا تُحَمِّلْنَا مَا لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا بِهِ وَاعْفُ عَنَّا وَاغْفِرْ لَنَا وَارْحَمْنَا أَنْتَ مَوْلَانَا فَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ Final words are the same. فَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ Help us against these people who don't believe in you, who don't believe in the hereafter, who don't believe in your messengers, who don't believe in your scriptures, who don't believe in your books, who are not submitting to you, who are not bondsmen to you. Help us, O Allah. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafani wa iyaakum bil ayati wa zikr al-Hakim.
Allahu Akbar,
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.